Hi, this is Shruti Joshi and I'm going to talk about transfemoral gait deviation. Let's see that. So first is circumduction. When circumduction is occur, when the prosthesis swing in arc this way, like this way, swing in arc, circumduction gait deviation will occur. So what are the cause for that? If the knee is locked or there is abductors contracture, so your leg will circumduct to clear the ground. So how to remember this? Remember 3 long sip. 3L means long prosthesis. If long prosthesis is there, very little flexion and lock knee. If the socket is small, inadequate suspension or plantar flexion of foot. So 3 long sip. Let's see this video. In this video we are going to see about the circumduction gait. So here we can see that if the prosthesis is too long, then the amputee limb will swing to side and clear the ground. So there are some factors to produce excessive length are insufficient knee flexion. So if the patient is having insufficient knee flexion, here we can see that if the patient is having insufficient knee flexion and because of insecurity or falling fear, they will don't flex their knee, and that's why they have to circumduct their leg and clear the ground. If there is a manual lock here, so excessive friction will be there. If a tight extension aid is there, so this will prevent knee flexion, and if knee flexion is prevented, then knee will remain in extension, and that's why the patient has to clear the ground with circumduction. If suspension is inadequate, that allow the prosthesis to drop like pistoning action, and if the pistoning action is there, so patient will circumduct their leg because they are feeling uneasiness. And if the socket is too small, so if socket is too small and the ischial tuberosity above its proper location, means the socket is above its proper location, so because of that the patient will circumduct their leg and clear the ground. If foot is in excessive plantar flexion, so your knee will remain in extension, and that's why patient has to circumduct their leg and clear the ground. Let's see vaulting gait. So what is vaulting? The patient is rise up on sound limb to swing the prosthetic prosthesis. So how would you remember this? Remember 3 long sip, long prosthesis, little flexion, lock knee, small socket, inadequate suspension and plantar flexion of your foot. If the patient is having lock knee or abductor contracture, so they will have vaulting gait. So let's see how patient will vault. In this video we can see that patient is feeling some vaulting while walking. So if the patient is having insufficient knee friction, so maximum elevation of the body occurs and the other limb swings along the side. So here we can see that the maximum elevation is occur and the limb swings along it. So when there is a insufficient knee friction, heel rise is excessive. In this video we can see that heel rise is excessive and shanks takes a longer time to swing forward, and that's why this time lag the body is no longer in maximum elevation, and that's why the prosthetic foot is at lowest point in swing throw, and prosthetic foot would fail to clear the ground unless the amputee gained additional time, and that's why they will vault. See here, they will vault and clear the ground. If excessive length of the prosthesis is there, amputee again vaults because they want to gain additional clearance to for their prosthetic foot, and they will do some vaulting to clear the ground. There are some factors which is responsible for excessive length. They are insufficient knee flexion. If the patient is having insufficient knee flexion because they are feeling that prosthesis is not good, they might fall, and that's why they have insecurity and fear, and they have insufficient knee flexion, so they will vault to clear the ground. If manual knee lock is there, so excessive knee flexion will be occur, and too tight extension aid is there, again the patient has to vault their limb to clear the ground. If inadequate suspension is there, the prosthesis is slip off and stump, slip off the stump means pistoning action will occur. So during pistoning action, the patient will again vault their limb to clear the ground. Again, if the patient is having too small socket, so they will feel some pressure at the ischial tuberosity and it's above the proper location, and that's why they will vault their leg. If the patient is having excessive plantar flexion, so knee will remain in extension and they will vault. Let's see about abducted gait in transfemoral gait deviation. So what will occur in abducted gait? There will be wide based gait is there. Normally the lateral wall is high and medial wall is low in the prosthetic patients. However, when the patient is having abducted gait, either they have high medial wall and low lateral wall. So how you will remember this? Remember wall long P. So if the prosthesis is long and if your wall medial wall is high and lateral wall is low, so patient has to abduct their limb to clear the ground. Remember, if the patient is having discomfort or pain in the crotch area, so what will happen? That it might be because of some skin infection, some adductor roll is there, there is a pressure area, there is some more pressure at the medial socket, and that's why amputee tries to relieve by abducting his prosthesis, and therefore it's moving to the medial part of brim and away from painful area, and that's why patient is abducting their leg. In this diagram we can see that the patient will abduct their leg if they are having pain here, and if patient is feeling that there is some infection and they don't want to weight bear, and that's why they will abduct their leg immediately. If the patient is having contracted hip abductors, again there is a wide base gait is there. If prosthesis is too long, means if your prosthesis is long, excessive length is there, so it is difficult to place the limb directly under the hip during stance phase. So in order to clear the foot, or during swing time, if we want to clear the foot, the patient will slightly abduct their limb and clear the ground. So this wide based gait will help to solve this kind of the problem. If the patient is feeling insecurity, so the amputee compensates by widening his walking base. Here in this diagram we can see that if the patient is having new prosthesis and he is feeling insecure, so if he is walking with the wide base, so he'll feel more comfortable and he will try to walk with abducted gait. So we have to remember that for abducted gait, wall long P means high medial wall, low lateral wall, and long prosthesis. Let's see lateral trunk bending transfemoral gait deviation. So what happens in this? The amputee leans toward the amputated side. So here the patient is having low lateral wall, high medial wall. normally the lateral wall is high, medial wall is low. So here it is opposite, and that's why the patient leans toward the affected side. If the short amputee limb, means the amputee limb is short, again patient will lean toward amputated side. If weakness of hip abductors or contracture of abductor is there, patient will lateral bend their trunk. If the patient is having hip pain, again the patient will bend laterally. In this video we can see that the patient is bending laterally toward the prosthetic side. So this is called lateral trunk bending gait deviation. So when there is weak hip abductors, your COG, means center of gravity, will fall or shift towards the prosthesis, and that's why the lateral bending counteracts the tendency toward the pelvic drop. Means if the patient is having pelvic drop on sound side, and to counteract that, the patient will lean toward the prosthetic side. If the socket is abducted, again it will reduce the effectiveness of hip abductors in stabilizing the pelvis. We all know that normally the hip abductors is stabilize the opposite pelvis. So as a result of this pelvis drop on sound limb, to counteract that, again the patient will lean on amputated side. If there is insufficient support by lateral socket wall, if there is insufficient lateral wall socket support, normally the lateral wall is high, medial wall is low. Here it is opposite. So the lateral wall is not block the lateral movement of femur. That's the result, the pelvis drop on the sound side. And when there is pelvis drop on sound side in stance limb or stance face, the patient will again counteract with the lateral trunk bending. Again, if the patient is having pain at the hip joint, particularly the distal, lateral distal area, here lateral distal area, again near the part of the femur, if the patient is having problem, then again patient will bend toward the prosthetic side and amputee relieves the pressure on lateral aspect. So if the patient is having short limb, means if the shortened limb is there, that is also responsible for lateral bending, because if the shortening is there, patient will try to lean on affected side. Let's see about terminal swing impact. So what is terminal swing impact? First of all, we need to know about the swing impact. It means sudden stop at the extension period. If your leg is suddenly stopped during the extension and it is audible sound, this is called swing impact. And during the terminal swing it's occur, that's why it's called terminal swing impact. So what is main cause? Inadequate knee friction. It always occur at late swing phase. So how would you remember this? Remember, too much fear or tension of hip friction, means if there is too much tension in extension aid or shank snaps forward in full extension because of inadequate knee friction. That's why too much fear or tension of hip friction. Let's see, in this prosthetic patients, there will be some variable friction needed during the gait cycle. So at early swing, there is a high resistance is needed to prevent heel rise. At mid swing, your limb will move forward, so minimum friction is needed. But at the terminal swing or at late swing, more friction is needed to prevent the swing impact. So if there is inadequate knee friction is there, so there will be some problem. In terminal swing impact, there is insufficient friction at prosthetic knee. There is tight extension aid, especially the patient is feeling the fear of knee buckling. That's why it causing him to extend the hip abruptly and knee approaches in full extension. And that's why this maneuver snaps the shank forward into full extension, and one sound is coming which is audible during the extension. That's why it's called terminal swing impact. Let's see heel rise transfemoral gait deviation. So it occurs at late swing. There is too little tension in extension aid. Normally the prosthetic heel rise higher than the sound limb. Here in a heel rise, inadequate heel rise is there. So there is prosthetic heel rise is less than the sound heel. Let's see in this video. Here heel rise occur if there is a insufficient tension or absence of extension aid. That's why there is a forceful, we can see here, there is a forceful hip flexion, and to ensure this, the prosthetic knee will extend fully at heel strike. And there, if there is a insufficient heel strike, there are some cause for it. If the patient is having excessive friction at prosthetic knee or fear of insecurity, the amputees walk with little or no knee flexion. Here we can see that the little knee flexion is there and more hip flexion is there. Let's see about the lumbar lordosis in transfemoral gait deviation. So while lumbar lordosis, the trunk lean posteriorly. So how will you remember this? Remember high PW. High means H, hip flexors contracture. I means insufficient support from anterior or posterior wall. Insufficient support from anterior or posterior wall. PW means painful ischial. If the patient is having weak extensors or abductors, then there is a lumbar lordosis. Normally the COG is always anterior to the sacral vertebra, and the pelvis is tilted downward and forward. But if the patient is having flexure contractures, so their hip flexors are shortened, and because of this it will pull the pelvis more downward, like more downward and forward. So forward tilting of the pelvis, and it will limit the extension. If there is a insufficient support from the anterior socket beam, the body will go for lumbar lordosis. If the patient is having weak hip extensors, so what happens? If the extensors are lost, then result in the forward pelvic tilt, and there is a compensatory backward trunk bending, and this is called more exaggerated lumbar lordosis. If the abdominals are weak, then there is again a problem. If the abdominals are weak, lead to the anterior pelvic tilt and lumbar lordosis, because there is a tight erector spinae. If the erector spine is tight, as a result we can see that there is an exaggerated lumbar lordosis, strong pull of the psoas muscle down, and that's why the patient is having anterior tilting or forward tilting of pelvis. Let's see forward flexion at stance. So what happened in this? During forward flexion at the stance phase, your trunk will bend forward. So how would you remember this? In India we have the Usha fan, so I remember with Usha. So just remember USH. So first is unstable knee unit, second is short ambulatory aid, and third H means hip flexion contracture. Let's see about the heel strike in transfemoral gait deviation. So during heel strike there are two gait deviation. Either your limb will go for external rotation at heel strike, or there is a foot slap at heel strike. So what are the cause for it? If the foot is malaligned, as your heel contracts to the ground, the foot rotates laterally. If there is a too hard heel cushion, You will try to push your leg and it will go for external rotation. Again, if the plantar flexor bumper is too hard, then your knee will go for external rotation. Let's see foot slap at heel strike. What happens then? What are the causes for that? If the foot plantar flexes too rapidly, this is the foot. If it is plantar flexed too rapidly and strikes to the floor with slap, there is an audible sound, so it's called foot slap. When there is a plantar flexion bumper is soft and it is not enough offer to resistance, and that's why the foot motion means the weight of the foot is transferred to the prosthesis, and this is the main reason why your foot is slapping again and again. Let's see in this video. Here in this video, we can see that the foot is slapping again and again because the plantar flexor bumper is too soft. Let's see the swing phase whip at toe off. So what happens in this? If your leg is going for external rotation, there is medial whip, so your heel will move medially. If internal rotation of your leg is there, there is lateral whip, heels move laterally. So what are the causes for it? The malalignment of the knee bolt in transverse plane is the main cause for swing phase whip at toe off. When there is a suction available, or with the suction, or there is no auxiliary suspension available, whips may occur, because if your muscle is flabby, so it is not working, and that's why prosthesis will freely move around the femur. If the socket is too tight or improperly contoured, then again your muscle has to accommodate. If the pressure from contracting muscle pulls and cause the prosthesis to rotate around its prosthesis and its axis, then again there is a rotation of your limb. Let's see this. This is medial whip. Here we can notice that this is medial whip. How patient is moving? We can notice in both the leg and femur. This is lateral whip. Here we can notice that how the leg is moving externally. The last gait deviation is unequal or uneven step length. So what are the cause for it? If the socket is poor alignment, if socket discomfort is there, hip contracture or instability is there, we can notice that the shorter step on prosthetic side. Here in this video, we can notice that if the patient is walking, so there is unequal step length is there. So due to pain and insecurity, the amputee transfer his weight quickly from the prosthesis to his sound leg. Let's see. Because of pain, he is moving the leg quickly and transferring the weight. So to do this kind of activity, there is a rapid step with his sound foot. Remember, if there is a flexion contracture or insufficient socket flexion is there, there is a problem with restriction, and this is reflect the step length on the sound side, and that's why there is a uneven step length. If the patient is having insufficient knee friction at prosthesis side, or it is loosed in extension aid, again it is responsible for the unequal step length. If the pendular swings or shank produce prosthetic step length, this is longer than the step length on sound side. If there is a pendular swing like this way, if it is swinging continuously, then prosthetic step length is longer. Thanks friends for watching my videos and don't forget to subscribe. Lastly, I want to thanks my friend Priyanka. She made mnemonics for the all prosthetic gait deviation.